Janet and Rabia.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
This exercise is about a particle moving on a curved path. We are going to prove that the particle does not pass through the origin of coordinates. Calculate the angle that the position vector makes with the positive x-axis at time 1.2 seconds. Determine the instant at which the position vector is confounded with the y-axis. Show that the velocity of the particle cannot be zero. Calculate the instant at which the angle between the velocity vector and the positive x-axis is 45 degrees. Calculate the instant or instants at which the position vector is perpendicular to the velocity vector.
The position vector of a moving particle m in xy plane is given by 4ti plus t squared minus 2j in SI units. This animation shows the trajectory of m during the first 6 seconds. Number 1. Does the particle pass through the origin during its motion? Justify. The particle passes through the origin when x and y equal 0 at the same instant, but r equal xi plus yj, so x equal 4t and y equals t squared minus 2. At the origin, x equals 0 and y equals 0. So let's calculate the time t when x equals 0. 4t equals 0, then t equals 0. Now let's calculate the value of y when t equals 0. So substitute t equals 0 in the expression of y, therefore at time 0 y equals minus 2. Minus 2 does not equal to 0, therefore the particle doesn't pass through the origin during its motion.
Let's move to part 2. Determine the angle alpha that the position vector r makes with the positive x-axis at time 3 seconds. Let's start by calculating the abscissa and the ordinate at time 3 seconds. Replace t by 3 in the expression of the position vector. Therefore, at this instant, x equals 12 meters and y equals 7 meters. Here is the trajectory of the moving particle. We draw the position vector at time 3 seconds. Here is the abscissa at this instant, and here is the ordinate. And here is the angle alpha that the position vector makes with the positive x-axis. From the right-angled triangle in the figure, we can write tangent alpha equals y over x. Y is 7 meters, x is 12 meters, then tangent alpha equals 0.58. Using the calculator gives this answer, alpha equals 30.3 degrees. Now, an important remark. We do not always accept the answer of the calculator. In our question, x equals 12 meters, which is positive, and y equals 7 meters, which is also positive. Therefore, the particle is in the first quadrant. Alpha is between 0 and 90 degrees. The answer of our calculator is between 0 and 90 degrees. Then this value of alpha is acceptable. In other questions, if the answer of the calculator is not acceptable, we just add 180 degrees to this answer.
Focus, please. This is important.
Number 3. Determine the instant at which the position vector is confounded with the y-axis. The position vector is confounded with the y-axis when x equals 0, but x equals 4t, so 0 equals 4t, then r is confounded with the y-axis when t equals 0. Number 4. Determine the expression of the velocity vector of the particle. Given that if x equals at with a equals constant, then the time derivative of x equals a. And if x equals t to the power n with n is a constant, then the time derivative of x equals nt to the power n minus 1. And we know that the velocity vector is the time derivative of the position vector, or v equals r prime. X equals 4t, so x prime equals 4. Y equals t squared minus 2, then y prime equals 2t, then v equals 4i plus 2tj in SI units.
Let's move to part 5. Show that the velocity of this particle cannot be zero. Look at the components of the velocity vx equals 4 meters per second. Then vx is different from zero at any instant. If one of the components of a vector is different from zero at any instant, then this vector cannot be zero at any instant. Therefore, the velocity of this particle cannot be zero. Let's move to part 6. Determine the instant at which the angle between the velocity vector and the positive x-axis is 45 degrees. As we have seen in part 2, to calculate the angle that a vector makes with the positive x-axis, we use this equation. Tangent 45 equals the y component of the vector over the x component of the vector. The y component of the velocity is Vy, which is equal to 2t, and the x component is 4. This is going to be t over 2. Tangent 45 equals 1. Therefore, t equals 2 seconds. Observe the figure. We draw the velocity vector of the particle at time 2 seconds. This vector makes 45 degrees, as you see, with the positive x-axis.
Number 7. Determine the instant or the instants at which the position vector is perpendicular to the velocity vector. Given that I scalar I or I dot I equals 1, J scalar J equals 1, and I scalar J equals 0. We know that the position vector is perpendicular to the velocity vector when R vector scalar V vector equals 0. So 40i plus t squared minus 2j, which is equal to r, scalar 4i plus 2tj, which is equal to v vector, equals 0. According to these values, the dot product of these two expressions is given by the coefficient of I in the first expression multiplied by the coefficient of I in the second expression plus the coefficient of j in the first expression times the coefficient of j in the second expression. This is going to be 16t plus t squared minus 2 into 2t equals 0, or 2t cubed plus 12t equals 0. Now let's take t as a common factor. Then t into 2t squared plus 12 equals 0. But 2t squared plus 12 cannot be 0, since 12 is a positive number and t is also positive number. Therefore, the position vector is perpendicular to the velocity vector at time equals 0, as we see in this figure.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.